My name is Brian Willson with two L's, and I just finished my memoirs called Blood on the Tracks, The Life and Times of S. Brian Willson. About ready to hand cycle from Portland to San Francisco at the rate of about 40 miles a day on my book tour. My first public reading and signing, book signing, is tonight at the People's Co-op, which is June 24th. And then tomorrow morning, June 25th at 8 a.m. I leave. I wanted to be able to promote my book on my cycle rather than in a car. The book itself is a lot about our whole Western consumptive way of life and how destructive it is. I started my consciousness when I was in Vietnam. I was a very straight kid growing up. I was actually quite a star in my small town. And then my military experiences and my Vietnam experience just kind of shook me to my bones and to my soul, I guess, and I started walking on a different path. I spent a lot of time in Nicaragua and El Salvador, where President Reagan was launching wars against the poor. I was in a lot of villages. I saw a lot of killing. I knew the killing was happening because of U.S. weapons or U.S. money that was buying weapons for mercenaries. There was one moment in Nicaragua where I saw these six bodies on horse-drawn wagons coming in for burial in Esteli up in the mountains. And they'd been killed by a contre-attack nearby where I was living at the time. And I just saw those open caskets. It's kind of like I had a flashback to Vietnam right there, and it was like it all kind of synthesized in clarity that this is what imperialism's all about. It's about killing people who are in the way of whatever we want. It's called Blood on the Tracks because in 1987 I was protesting the movement of munitions to El Salvador and Nicaragua from the Department of War's major arsenal on the West Coast. A bunch of us were vigiling at the base for several months, and some people were blocking munitions trucks that were carrying the munitions to the ships, and some people were blocking trains. So I finally decided on September 1st, which was 3 months after we started, I would start a 40-day fast on the tracks blocking the trains. That day, an extraordinary event happened in that the train, which always stopped if there was anything on the tracks, accelerated to 3 times its 5-mile speed limit, and I didn't get all the way in time and went under the train and lost my legs. So it was my blood on the tracks. So between here and San Francisco, I'll probably have done 700,000 revolutions. And so that equals a new way of moving, which is what this logo on my shirt represents. Gandhi sitting at a bicycle wheel rather than a spinning wheel, and there's a butterfly coming out of the chrysalis. The caterpillar really battles a metamorphosis to a butterfly, and it's an intense battle. But the butterfly emerges from the chrysalis, and the butterfly treads very lightly and pollinates, whereas the caterpillar devours. It just is a metaphor for going from a car wheel to a bicycle wheel, and moving from a car culture to a bicycle culture. So 700,000 revolutions of my wheel equals a major revolution of transportation policy. But when the system starts to crack, we'll have to be ready to give it all back. And when the system